opening ourselves. Chest open, bare boned. Seeds within, bursting through. Pain confused with birth. Whoever said that birthing was painless? Whoever said that ripping and tearing of flesh, soul, and bone into becoming something new was painless? It is my prayer that we begin to see and feel and identify pain as something different than something that is wrong. For it is telling us exactly what it is that we need. It is a gift. It is heart-rending, soul-ripping. And it so deeply matters. So deeply. My heart hurts for the world. It just hurts. And it's okay. Hurt says, I am alive, I am here, I am present, and I'm not going anywhere. So I will take that hurt. I will take that pain. I will take those tears. I will take that rage, and I will turn it into something. We all do something with our pain, with our rage. What we do with it, what we birth from it, is the measure of its value. Speak to the pain in the world. It's a very serious time for some, and for others, they mock the level of emotions that people feel. Regardless of where people fall on the spectrum, the fact is that we as a country, as a world, as a civilization, as individuals, we are changing. We've always been changing, and now we are beginning to change even more rapidly. With all change comes pain. This pain must be acknowledged. It will not be denied. It will not be satisfied until it is felt and until it finishes what it is here to do, which is to tell us what we need next. We have to listen deeply to pain. In order to call our hearts home, we have to find out what has sent them away. Were they taken away? Did we let them go? Were they stolen from us in the middle of the night? Were we never shown that we had one to begin with? So many scenarios, so many possibilities, so many ways for how we have lost connection to our hearts, to the whys behind our pain. These chains that hold us are simply our lead line to find our way home. But when we cower and hide in the dark because we do not want to feel it, then we run away from our source home, our home to ourselves, our home to our hearts, our home to our next step in our growth, in our birth, in our change as individuals, as cultures and societies. And as the rain and the sleet pour down over this mountain this morning, I feel that change coming over us. And these mountains rumble in my bones and tell me it is so. So much love. So much love for the world. through sorrow and through tears. It's all beauty. It is all fodder for the gristmill. It is all the pieces and the wrappings and the wisps of our becoming. Deep honoring to the pain. Deep honoring.